It is told in the scriptures that Elijah, God's great prophet, fled to a cave and hid there from the evil king and queen Ahab and Jezebel. That night, God spoke to Elijah, but not in the windstorm or in the earthquake that shook the mountain or in the roaring fire that followed. Instead, God spoke to Elijah in a small, still voice, a whisper. Matthew and Luke tell us in their Gospels that many years later, God again spoke to his people in a still, small voice, the still, small voice of a special child. Again, it was night, calm, and silent when God spoke. Again, there was a cave, a stable carved from a hill just outside the village of Bethlehem. And the prophet that time was the new Elijah, God's greatest prophet, the Messiah, the Savior of the world, the child Jesus. Outside that evening, the world prepared to rest from another day of toil. Suppers were eaten. Dishes were cleaned and put away. Family members went about their evening activities until it was finally time to put out the lights and go to sleep. It was on this night, long ago and far away, that Jesus, the Son of God, was born. All was calm, all was bright, silent was the night.
Peace on the stars shone.
that time, Caesar Augustus decreed that all the people should return to their hometowns to be enrolled in a census. So Joseph and Mary, his wife, who was pregnant, started out from Galilee to Bethlehem, the city of David, because Joseph was a descendant of David. The road was dark as they approached Bethlehem. The silvery stars glittered brightly in the clear sky. Joseph walked along in silence, holding the donkey's reins, leading the way. Mary sat on the animal and stared ahead, watching for the distant glow from the village's lights, a signal that their long journey from Nazareth was about to end. As Joseph walked, the quiet of the night reminded him of the 23rd Psalm. He recalled the words and repeated some of them to himself. The Lord is my shepherd. He leads me beside still waters. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for he is with me. Ahead lay the village of Bethlehem, crowded with travelers who came for the census. Soon, the many oil lamps would die out, and the village would sleep. In the fields nearby, shepherds gathered around their campfires and prepared for the long night ahead.
Pastures green by streams serene.
Joseph and Mary had no sooner arrived in Bethlehem than it was time for Mary to give birth. Since there was no room for them in the town's crowded inn, the child was born in a stable wrapped in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger. Lying in a bed of fresh hay, the child slept soundly, unaware of his simple surroundings. Mary and Joseph rested from their journey and quietly watched the sleeping child. Admiration and joy filled their hearts. God's promise to Mary had come true. The Messiah was born. They named the child Jesus, or Emmanuel, which means God with us. The cattle and oxen slumbered peacefully in their stalls as they shared their home with the Holy Family. All was calm. All was bright. Silent was the night. At the same time, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born King of the Jews? We have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him." Herod was king of the region at that time. After learning of Jesus' birth from his chief priests and scribes, he summoned the wise men and sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search carefully for the child. When you have found him, bring me word so that I may come and worship him also." The wise men set out, and the star seemed to go before them, finally stopping over Bethlehem. When they saw this, they rejoiced, for they knew that this would be the place where God's Messiah, the Christ, had entered the world to bring salvation. As the prophet Isaiah had announced long before, a light to all nations had been born in Judea. The wise men's journey was nearly over. It was a good night, a perfect night. The shepherds, one by one, settled down by the campfire's warm embers. Another day's work was over. It was time to rest at the end of a long day. All was calm, all was bright. Silent was the night. Thank you. shepherds and flocks were resting peacefully in the still night. Then overhead, without warning, the glory of God burst forth from the heavens, an almost blinding light. An angel appeared to the shepherds, and they were terrified. But the angel said, "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy. To you is born in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. You will find him wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." Suddenly, the sky was filled with angels singing God's praises. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all with whom he is pleased. And when the angels went away, the shepherds went to the village to see what had happened. There they found Mary and Joseph watching over the child lying in the manger. They knelt before the family with heads bowed low, their hearts filled with joy, and their minds filled with the glorious music of the angels. Glory to God, the Messiah has come. Then the wise men left as quietly as they had come. Mary and Joseph watched them disappear into the dark night. Having been warned in a dream, the wise men went home a different way without telling Herod where the Christ child was. All was calm, all was bright, silent was the night. The angels were gone, their heavenly music replaced by silent stars. The shepherds had come and gone too. The wise men from the east were on their way home. The night was quiet and calm again. An oil lamp bathed the room in soft light. The child slept soundly, cuddled in his mother's arms. Mary began to think about all that had recently happened in her life. The journey to Bethlehem, the birth of Jesus, the visits of the angels and shepherds and wise men, and, as the scripture says, she pondered these things in her heart. So let us also ponder these mighty events of God in our hearts. Let us make room in our lives for Christ to dwell within us and bring us such